Hey, it's Mazzy, welcome back. This is the companion piece I was talking about in the other video, in the San Francisco 1960s psychedelic scene, a bibliography of art and scribes. And if you're here first, there's a link below, go watch that video. This is simply gonna be a flip through of my handbill poster collection that I collected mostly in the 60s into the 70s. And let me tell you a little bit about these. These are posters from the Carousel Ballroom that became the Fillmore West. Now, Bill Graham started the Fillmore on Fillmore and Geary. He had to move it eventually, and he took over the Carousel Ballroom on Market Street at South Van Ness, and that became the Fillmore West, both in the same city. He also produced shows a little later at Winterland, and then across town, or actually on Sutter at Van Ness, Chet Helms and his collective called The Family Dog produced shows at the Avalon, then occasionally at the Great Highway, and there are some, there was a Family Dog in Denver as well. So these are the poster art from my collection. Artists like Wes Wilson, Bonnie McLean, Stanley Mouse, Anton Alton Kelly, Rick Griffin, Lee Conklin, Greg Irons, Randy Tootin, David Byrd, David Singer, Norman Orr, and possibly a few others. I noticed there was a poster from the Straight Theater that used to be the Haight Movie Theater right on Haight Street, and it was transformed during the whole 66, 67, 68 period, and it was named the Straight Theater. Ironically, the Straight Theater was the first time the Beatles' Magical Mystery Tour was shown. The Beatles sent it to San Francisco as a benefit for the Straight Theater, and that was the first time it ever hit our shores in the United States. When I was a young lad of 13, I discovered after getting these handbills, they would give these handbills out at the shows, some, the larger posters you'd get at the shows at these various venues, but you'd get the handbills at bookstores and head shops and all kinds of places, record stores around the Bay Area advertising the shows. But I discovered that you could call up and you could get on the Fillmore's mailing list and the Avalon Family Dog's mailing list. So a lot of these posters I got back in the day. And as you can see, some of them I had mounted in a black scrapbook for literally four decades. And the last five, 6 years, I put them in these acid-free sleeves, very much like baseball card sleeves. So you're gonna see a flip through. And they're not in order, they're not by venue, but I just picked them out. And what's nice is I finally, a few years ago, these are all the posters. A few others, off-size posters don't fit in here, but these are my flip-through collection of about 130 or so, give or take. Fillmore, Avalon, Winterland, Family Dog, etc. Art posters. I love these and I'm glad, unlike some young people, they didn't get destroyed along the way, or my parents didn't throw them out. I'm very mindful of my collection. Now, the music I played, I decided to pick from this great debut, Quicksilver Messenger Service. Love this. This is a Rick Griffin cover and a Jim Marshall series of photographs. I'm going to show some books of Jim Marshall, a great photographer. And I'm going to use the closing song, The Fool, with the great John Cipollina's guitar playing, Gary Duncan, as well, Greg Elmore on drums, and David Freiberg vocals and bass. My favorite album of theirs, their debut album on Capitol Records from 1968. Saw them many times. So without further ado, here is my handbill poster collection. Go check out the other video, link below.
Thank you. burning out, spirals high.